Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming a quick swatch party video of my latest palette purchase. This is the Huda Beauty Mercury Retrograde palette. Now I did ask you guys on Instagram what you wanted me to do with this palette, and I really wanted to be able to deliver an eye look and stuff like that, but I'm really just not in the mood to take my eyeshadow off that I've had on all day and redo my makeup. So hopefully you guys don't mind, but maybe I'll do an eye look next go around with that palette. Today I have on the Alien palette by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I randomly decided to do a week of looks with the Jeffree Star eyeshadow palettes. So I own four of them. I have the Alien, the Blue Blood, the Blood Sugar, and the Jawbreaker palette. And since he's coming out with a new palette this Friday with Shane Dawson, I thought, hey, let me pull out the new palettes because I'm really on the fence about if I want to buy the Jeffree Star Shane Dawson collab. I never end up going back to palettes once I play with them on camera, which is something I want to get better at. I want to go back to makeup, try it out, see if I feel the same way, whatnot. So I did decide to spontaneously do a little series on my Instagram. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, I think you might want to, especially if you're trying to decide on which palette to get. I don't have all of his palettes, but I stated the four I have, and this is the eye look I did with the Alien palette. I had a poll, or I posted a question on Instagram asking which palette I should use next. Not sure who's winning that one yet, but if you wanna go ahead and follow me on Instagram, and if you have a Jeffree Star palette, you wanna pull it out and use it, we're all using the hashtag 1 week of JSC so that I can keep track of your looks and repost them and give you guys shout outs if you join me. So just wanted to throw that in really quick. Now, as far as the Huda palette, this one is available on Huda Beauty's website. I bought this off of her Instagram. If you buy it on Instagram, you get free shipping. Whereas if you buy it on the website, the free shipping minimum is $75. And took me a while to figure it out, and I did go ahead and purchase it on Instagram because let me tell you, if I can get free shipping, I'm a happy camper. If I have to pay for shipping or if I have to hit a certain total, that's super annoying. It's so gimmicky, and this palette is definitely not cheap. It's not the most expensive palette I own, but for $67, like, I kind of want you to give me free shipping. So I really like the packaging. It's like the hard packaging. She started doing this hard packaging when she did her mini neon palettes, I believe. I forgot to grab those. I grabbed her big palettes that I own from her. So here they are right here. I really like this brand. I know they are a little bit controversial. I think the main controversies from her, or that are attached to the brand, was them not supporting gay people, I think, which I understand that's not the culture that most people grew up in where we live. But I know in the Middle East, it's a completely different culture, and Huda is based out of Dubai. So maybe that has something to do with it. I don't know. I'm not an expert on culture by any means. And then also the beauty bakery powders having the bake theme, and she did like a bake theme. I didn't really look into it, I'm not gonna lie. But I just filmed a collab with two of my other YouTube friends on this palette, and I think we all ended up loving each of the shades we got. So I'll try and remember to link those videos down below. I really want to pick up the medium palette during the Sephora sale potentially. So as you can see, there's not really too many like dupe type shades in here. I'm not really worried about that, but I did grab this just to show you guys the plastic packaging in the small version. It's nice, it's sturdy, it's beautiful. This is the one a lot of people are kind of just like, okay, aren't they basically the same thing? So I just wanted to show you guys side by side just so you could see the two palettes next to each other. I mean, Yeah, there's definitely some repeats of the neutrals. I mean, there's similarities, but I really like Huda's brand, so I wanted to pick this up and try it out. So I showed this to you guys the other day. This is my rose gold palette. This is the remastered version. And I really, really, really wasn't gonna buy this when she redid it, but I'm a sucker. And so I did buy it. As you can see, kind of different color stories here. And I really like this one. I need to use this. I think this is gonna end up in a try or buy video series that I'm supposed to be working on but haven't updated you guys on yet. And then this is her Desert Dust palette. This is her second big palette that came out, and so there they are just side by side so you guys can see them. I'm not gonna do like swatches comparing them side by side, but I am gonna swatch the new palette, so I hope you guys are excited. I haven't done a swatch party video in so long. They used to be like one of my favorite videos to film, but I kind of felt like I was not really like cheating you guys, but I didn't know that that was like the most difficult thing on YouTube to do, so I kind of stopped doing them. But a lot of people really, really appreciated my swatch parties, so I really just need to bring them back. So the shades feel really smooth. I just do like a little dip. I just like rub the swatches in. I don't like build them up or anything. I do want to give you guys like a realistic perspective of the swatches, so I try not to, I don't know, jazz them up, I guess. So here are the first five shades, and then let me get that last baby blue color so I can show you all of the shades on the first row. So here is the swatch of the blue. Ooh, that actually swiped on pretty nice, which is exciting because I know pastels, we'll have to see how it blends, but the swatch is beautiful. So the first row we have Cosmic, Utopia, Ultraviolet, Nebula, Mercury, and Haze. Honestly, this is the row that like really got me. There's some beautiful shimmery purples in here, and I don't know, I just think this is such a fun palette. I don't know that it necessarily screams like holiday palette to me, but I think you could do so many good like everyday beautiful neutral looks, and then you can just do some really fun glam holiday looks as well. So that's kind of what I am thinking this palette is gonna bring to the table with all the holiday releases that are coming out. So there are the shades in the second row, and then I need to swatch this beautiful white shade. This one just looks like an iridescent. Yeah, exactly what I thought it was gonna be. I think if my friend Amy was here, she would say that would be a beautiful inner corner shade. So let me read you the shade names. I've got Off Balance, Galaxy, Libra, Crash, Momentum, and Supermoon. And then let me just get that last color to show you guys. Ooh, that's pretty too. There it is. Do you guys see it? It's kind of like a duochrome vibe. So those shade names are Vortex, Hot Mess, Supernova, Karma, Gold, Glitch, and Frazzled. So now I'm gonna go ahead and insert some close-ups of the swatches. Okay guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and insert like some close-up swatches that I'm gonna film on my phone just so you guys can see the shimmers and the textures and stuff up close, because obviously like me just showing you my arm like this may not present the full picture for you. And then since the Sephora VIB sale is just around the corner here, I did pull out some other palettes that you might be considering buying at the sale, and maybe even this one. So I really like Huda. Huda has a great track record for me. Just based off of swatches, I don't know that I can recommend this to tan ladies like right away, because some of the mattes do look a little ashy. Like they're not really like, these three mattes are kind of like, why, you know? especially with my skin tone. But I do have the nude palette that I can pull in for some of those crease shades and stuff like that. The formula does seem very consistent to what I'm used to with Huda, very sparkly. And a lot of the times I will use glitter glue with shadows that have a lot of sparkle in them just to make it adhere to my lid. So I'm really, really sorry I'm not doing a look in this video. I just really, really don't want to take my makeup off and redo it. So I hope you guys understand. And then the other palette that just launched and I think is very, very similar to this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Carly Bible palette. Honestly, I just kind of saw some similarities right away. So if you have the Carly Bible palette and you really enjoy it, you might not want to purchase the Huda palette. Or again, like me, you might be a huge Huda fan, so maybe you'll want to have both. So yeah, I definitely see some similar shades. Definitely the shade Mandela and Ultraviolet are very similar. And then of course the rosy tone shimmers, I think you can definitely dupe the vibes with the Anastasia palette. And then I also wanted to show you guys the Jackie Ina palette next to the Huda palette. Again, because I'm sure as you guys are, you know, trying to narrow down which palettes you want to get. If you don't live near a Sephora, which is my situation, I'm hoping just seeing these next to each other is kind of going to give you an idea of what you can expect from these palettes, because you don't get to see them before you buy them. And I swear, if I got to see these palettes in person before I bought each one of them, I think they would have, it would have been easier for me to say no to some of these, you know? So anyway, this is the Pat McGrath Mothership 6 palette. This is her newest palette that came out, and definitely that purple shade again in the Pat McGrath number 6 is very reminiscent of the Ultraviolet palette in the Huda Beauty palette. Of course, the price difference really starts kicking in with Pat McGrath. So like I've told quite a few people that have asked me over the last few days about Pat McGrath, I love Pat McGrath shadows, but Mothership 6 isn't necessarily my favorite, and her holiday quads definitely left something to be desired. So I just want to make you guys aware of that. And then honestly, my number one recommendation of what you should pick up during the Sephora sale is this guy. I feel like I've already talked to you guys, like talked you guys' ear off about this palette, but honestly, I love this color combo so much. I can even see people using this in the summertime. I don't think this is a fall holiday time palette. I think this is an all year round palette. Definitely one of my favorite Natasha Denona palettes that I own. And then here is the Huda palette next to the Natasha Denona. As you can see, they're definitely very, very different. There are a few pops of blue in here as well as the Natasha Denona. But I can tell you the Natasha Denona formula from this particular palette is impeccable, you guys, impeccable. And then the other palette, since I featured this quite recently in a video, I want to show you guys the Manny palette. I just did a look with this, and again, I know this is one that a lot of you have your eye on for the Sephora sale, and hey, maybe this is like totally your witchy Halloween holiday dreams come true. And I think so far from the two times I've used the Moon Spell, I like it, but I wouldn't say it's to die for. Like, I wouldn't put the same clout, haha, you see how I use that word, clout behind this one as I would with the Metropolis, because I just think the Metropolis is stunning. But here is a side-by-side next to these in case you were, you know, trying to decide, should I get this one or this one? Or maybe you're gonna get both. Honey, I am not here to judge you. I am so excited that there are so many wonderful options these days for different skin tones, people looking for textures, if you like pressed glitters. Like, there's something out there for everyone, or at least most everyone, because, you know, I don't want to like put myself in a box and say everyone can find something they love, because maybe there's somebody out there that's missing the palette they desire. But for the most part, there's so much variety here. So I hope you found this video helpful. I will do a look. I just didn't want to do a look at like 7 o'clock at night. So I hope you guys understand. The other thing I do want to remind you guys is if you would please take the time and shop my Sephora link during the sale. It would mean so much to me. I like don't ever pimp out my like links and stuff, and I posted a little recommendations list on my community tab, and I think two of my subscribers like used the links and shopped, and it, you know, gave me enough kickback where it really made me feel so good about my recommendations and the fact that like people took the time to use my link. So I'm sorry if this comes off as like me like putting pressure on you guys or anything like that. It's not it. I just think it's a great way if you guys wanted to support me and just like help me put back into the channel, because as you guys can tell, I do love playing with new makeup and it's definitely like a huge hobby of mine. So I would really, really appreciate that. And I'm gonna get out of here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think. We're so close to 4,000 subscribers. I have my fingers crossed that we're gonna do it. So anyway, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.